One of the reasons I haven't been making videos as frequently lately is that I have been distracted by the worthwhile pursuit of playing games on my new Steam Deck. And one of the main things I've been playing on my new Steam Deck is Elden Ring on my PlayStation 5. The way I've been doing that is through an app called Chiaki, which existed well before the Steam Deck. It's a Windows, Linux, I think it's on a lot of other platforms, streaming service that replicates Sony's official remote PlayStation software, but allows for a lot more flexibility in control and platform. When I got Chiaki set up on my Steam Deck, I actually had a lot of trouble finding settings that worked right for it in my context. So I figured I'd make a quick video just to show what those settings are that work for me. I use these and get basically a native level experience on the deck, by which I mean I can play a game like Elden Ring, which is very reliant on quick timing and reflexes, as though I were playing it on my TV. There's no input lag. I get very rare moments of visual glitches, but otherwise the game genuinely looks better than I think it could have looked if I bought this game on Steam, since it's running off the PS5 at a native 60 frames per second. So here are the settings that I use. I should caveat these by pointing out that in my hardware setup, I have my PS5 hardwired to my router. I have a Wi-Fi 6 router, and my Steam Deck is connected to the 5 gigahertz channel of that Wi-Fi router. I don't know which one of those is more important than the other, but that's the combination that I'm working with to allow me to use these settings. Most of the things I read about Chiaki in trying to get it set up before suggested really low settings for the video and audio bandwidth settings here. I actually found that cranking them up much higher works better. The Steam Deck outputs at 800p, so it's not really necessary to do 1080p, but I haven't actually noticed any difference in terms of the quality of the video. Maybe slightly better with 1080p just because you're downscaling from a high resolution video, which does help a little bit, I think, with artifacting and stuff. But if you're having issues with bandwidth or lag or whatever, that would probably be the first setting I might tweak. Otherwise, you can see the settings here. This is a great gameplay experience. I played God of War on my PS5 all the way through using this setup. That's another game that's very reliant on reflexes and timing, and it worked great. I honestly feel like I could play games like Rocket League or first-person shooters in this setup and not have too much trouble, which I couldn't have said was true even a year or two ago using any other streaming setup I've basically ever used. The closest I've gotten to this was probably streaming PS5 on my phone and then using the PS Play app and then using one of those controller hookups like the Razer Kishi. But that's not nearly as satisfying as the Steam Deck, which has full analog sticks. It's comfortable in the hand, not just in the way a good handheld is, but in the way that a good controller is. When I first saw images of the Steam Deck, that's what I was hoping for. It looked like they had prioritized an ergonomics around the experience of playing console games rather than what do other handhelds do. One thing that I think is really interesting about the Steam Deck is that portability doesn't necessarily mean transportability in this case. So I actually think the Steam Deck is built for a primary use case of being at home but away from your TV or desktop computer. Say you're on the couch and someone else is watching TV, or you're watching TV and you want a mindless game on the side. Say you're taking a lunch break and you're at your work computer in your remote work setup and you want a few minutes to level up a character in Final Fantasy XIV. The Steam Deck understands something that I think the Switch almost got, which is that portability is more about convenience than it is about the literal portability. Now, it's also useful that you could take this on a train or a plane or a car ride, but I certainly am doing that a lot less in the past few years. So the value in the Steam Deck comes less from the ability to do that and more from the ability to just grab your PC library and play it wherever in your own home or right outside your own home that you want. For me, a lot of the decisions about the deck make a lot more sense in this context, and it makes the few negatives you might have a lot easier to handle. Battery life, for example, just doesn't matter if you're always pretty close to an outlet. Ergonomics from the standpoint of weight matter less when you aren't expecting to pocket the item because you're not trying to take it somewhere over a long distance. The Steam Deck is basically the perfect portable for what I want out of a portable, which is simply a mechanism by which there are fewer barriers for me to play a bunch of games that I want to play but that I never bother to play because it takes too much time to set up and then sit at a PC. I'm almost certainly going to play Rogue Legacy 2 at some point soon, and that's despite the fact that the game is only available on PC, and despite the fact that it is exactly the kind of roguelike that you would want to play on something like the Switch, because it's the perfect pickup for a run or two, 15-minute sessions kind of game. That's what the deck is, to me. It's not about taking it out on the road. Anyway, this really was just a video because I saw a bunch of people on Reddit who didn't seem to know the right settings for Chiaki or who were having issues with it, and I had posted a few different times the same settings and finally figured I should just make a video. And then also noticed that I hadn't made a video in a while except for that one where I made a very dumb joke and then let the video run on for 15 minutes. Sorry about that. Hope this slightly makes up for it, and I will talk to you later.